opened in January 2011, soon after receiving our green certification. We're one of the first GDI buildings in Malaysia, the first of six. And that was very important to us to get that standing, because we believe in the concept of accessibility and living with art and living spaces that people can associate with. So when we opened in January 2011, we had a lecture series which brought curators to Malaysia to speak to public audiences. And that series was published by UNESCO. It's online, you can see it on our website. So, you know, we have we're a cultural institution. We're beyond just a commercial gallery. We like to engage with the public and get artists and audience and curators involved, both locally and internationally. So it's local and global and, you know, multidisciplinary and an appreciative exercise.
This is something new in Malaysia, is it?
I think we try to be different.
Oh, you try to be different.
We try to be different and we try to make an impact. So everyone contributes in their own way. You know?
Yeah, but not so many people know about this, even those, I think, the artists also.
They do. We have a list. We have, we have a very active Facebook. So I believe that we could always use more support, and we would love to have more people hear about the gallery. So it's wonderful that you've come to visit us. We grow slowly.
Grow slowly.
And I think people who are really interested do come.
Oh, I see.
You know, they find out about us and they come.
So let's say if the artists want to hold an exhibition here, what are the procedures?
That's a little different. We only represent or show the artists whom we select and whom we represent. So exhibiting is a different exercise altogether. We open our doors for artists to attend our lectures and our community projects, and sometimes when curators come, we have portfolio reviews, and that's open to artists who sign up.
More than just an art gallery, sometimes you've got the art and culture show.
Yes,
dance
we have
as well.
Artist residencies, we have curatorial residencies, we have research residencies. You can see that we have a research and resource center. And really, this is all about using what we make from the gallery to fund all our non-profit. We have outreach programs, something called Art Hub, where we deal with empowerment. Mm-hmm. We promote children talking about art and drawing and talking about art.
I see.
So we have a variety of things that keep us busy.
So 1 year, then you'll be on and off, there'll be program going on, is it?
Yes, yeah. And so our Facebook will always list, and our website.
So on and off, so you all will be help some arts exhibition over here.
That's right.
So
for example, now we have BB2,
yeah,
which is featured upstairs, yeah. And then downstairs we have a general collection with Kim Ng, Zap Lee, Ani Malian, Xia Yiling, Eric Pierce.
So the upstairs is only for the exhibition by the solo artists?
Generally, but not always. It's a dedicated exhibition. Sometimes we have group shows as well.
So the downstairs is open for some artists?
Sometimes. No, it's always artists we choose.
I see.
Always artists we choose. So that's a little more difficult. It's much more, we're much more selective about the artists who we choose.